like this one.
What's up, everybody? It's your boy Wes Grant. You're watching Sub Urban Nerdist channel that I give my nerd views on today's nerd news. I also do this thing that I call unboxing whatever I want. Whatever I want usually entails me unboxing a statue or figure of a comic book character, anime character, or just any type of character that I find interesting. Or a lot of times I just want to open up some boxes or packages I got just to show you guys what I got. And today is something that I've had for a bit. Like I have a lot of collectibles, a lot of things that I've bought that are just sitting in boxes, and I figure since, you know, I have free time, I just open it up and show you guys. So this is something that the box, it seems a decent size, but it doesn't seem as big. What I bought was the Infinity War Thor Stormbreaker, right? So I'm hoping that maybe some pieces, you know, put it together. Because, I'm looking forward to this. So let's see how this is. This is a DSLR. Just sounds so good opening the boxes. Go there. Let's see how this. Okay. Let's see. What the like, it's not quite what I thought. Thought maybe in pieces to add it, put it together, because, you know, I figured maybe the X might be the same size as this, maybe, but no, not quite. Ain't give me that. At least to say, I'm very disappointed, because I got this axe, which is from the God of War game, that I got from GameStop when the game came out, and I wanted to put them side by side, and this is it. Like, it's a fraction of, like, it's literally a fraction of the size. Like, I wanted to have a cool kind of thing going on with these both, but I don't know if I can. Like, Jesus Christ, look at this. It looks like this one gave birth to this one. Like, it's tiny. Papa Bear, Baby Bear, like. Jesus, man. I'm really thinking about sending this. This is a toy. This isn't a Stormbreaker. This is a little thing. Jeez, this is... No! Like, I really want to have them side by side, but... Like, hang them. I wanted to hang them like this on a wall, but... I'm not quite sure if it's gonna work out like that, because this... This is tiny. This was like, I guess, on Amazon, it's 30, but... On other websites, you can get on eBay, maybe for like... 2015 or something. It's not worth it. I'm telling you right now, it's not. I think I might send it back. This is very small. It's smaller than I thought. It's really smaller than I thought. I can't recommend this. This is supposed to be the Stormbreaker that Thor aimed for the head in Endgame. This is the Stormbreaker? Like my head's bigger than, like, Stormbreaker's bigger than a head. This thing's smaller than my head. Like, I can't recommend this. I mean, maybe if you have like a toddler or a little kid, maybe 5 years old, this would be the size of his head, so maybe he'd be like, oh yeah, he feels like Thor. But if you're collecting to, you know, sort of do what I was doing, I don't recommend this at all. Like, the painting quality is decent. It's decent. I'll give him that. The paint job is decent as far as that. You know, you get to see from angles, like how the stick looks here, but it's pretty much a simple paint coat. Like, it's not much. And then the inside, they're pretty sloppy. They're very sloppy when it came to the inside is this. You see how it's on the edge and not just dead center in the middle? Really sloppy. Like, the quality isn't as good as people made it out to be. You know, some people are saying it was small, but I didn't know if it was going to be that small. Like, if you want to look at comparison, the quality of the painting, like, this is different color, and it stays pretty much this. Like, you see right there, even inside the ruins, they stayed inside the carvings to see the shape and whatever. Like, this is really good quality. It's a foam, too. I think it was like $20 when I got it at a thing. But also, if you want to, I made it so this glows. If you want to check that video out, you know, probably check over there. Oh, was it there? Oh, whichever one. But yeah, so that's my unboxing. Very disappointing for Stormbreaker. I'm sorry. I can't. It seems like the only word is coming out. I can't keep this. I just can't. I don't recommend it. Like I said, if you're getting it for a little kid, I think it's going to be great. It's good enough, but like, make sure you check some price tags, like, because don't get ripped off of this. I saw someone on Amazon said they paid $50 for this. It's not worth it. I did not pay $50 for it. Just know that. I did not pay $50 for this. So just buy at your own risk. And some of the other ones that I saw with the coloring, it looked even worse. Like, it was like darker and just had like some... It was dark, like some sort of thing right here, and that's not the way Stormbreaker looks. The Stormbreaker has distinct colors right in the middle, nothing here and here. So that's my review for Stormbreaker, 1.1 scale, which that is not 1-to-1 scale. Just believe that. That is not 1-to-1. That is like 1/3, 2/3 to 1, or something like that. It is not 1-to-1. So that's my review. Make sure you like this video. Make sure you share this video. Tell people, because Do not waste your money with that. Remember to subscribe. Check out my last unboxing. Check out my playlist unboxing. Remember, I'm Wes Grant. You've been watching Suburban Nerd. You've just been nerdified. Catch you guys on the next unboxing.